Next.js is amazing.
Ooh.
Does that sound convincing? Hey everybody, Trash back again at NextConf, and if you saw my talk last year about tRPC, you'll know that I love TypeScript. So much that I actually made the insane decision to build a platform for you to get better at it, typehero.dev. But you know, we're not here to talk about that, we're here to talk about Next.js. Before we start, I want to clarify that I'm not here to tell you that the Next.js framework or the Vercel ecosystem is amazing. To be honest, you're probably watching this right now because you already feel that way, or you're just interested in the technology already. So instead of me sounding like a sales pitch, I'm going to walk you through the story of how the TypeHero team leveraged the Next.js features and the Vercel ecosystem to help us iterate extremely fast over the past couple of months. And if you find yourself in a similar situation, the hope is that this talk can guide you to make maybe similar technical decisions. Cool, that's out of the way. So let's take it back to the beginning. Let's talk about how you even decide to choose a framework before you create a site, right? So these days, there's tons of great choices. There's Next, Remix, Solid, Astro, Vue, Angular. So how do we choose? So let's consider the requirements for TypeHero. We have, or we need SEO, we need nested routes, server rendering, obviously, performance, of course, and a couple other like cookie cutter requirements. And given these requirements, Next.js really stood out to me. And I'll give you a couple reasons why. I'm not going to give you like this huge exhaustive list. So one big reason is Next.js is the only framework at the moment that has adopted React Server Components. And there's a feature in React Server Components that really intrigued me, and that's streaming with suspense. And TLDR of that is it's just going to allow us to have pages that display ridiculous amounts of data. It's going to allow us to display pieces of the page as that data is available, versus in today's world, you pretty much have to wait for all that data to be fetched before you display a page. The next big one is nested routes. And the ability to just use file-based routing to accomplish this easily was a huge factor for me in this decision-making.
But Trash, file-based routing, give me a config file.
Yes, I actually do agree with you there. I do love a config file. I love a nice config file. But I can't deny, after trying nested routes in Next.js, it was actually pretty chill. Cool, so I made my technical decisions. We settled on Next.js. And now we actually just have to start building this. So I typically build in public almost always, whether that means Twitch, Discord, Twitter, I guess, or what have you. And it turned out a lot of people were pretty excited to work on this with me. So there's this cool visual I want to show you that I think will kind of drive the point home. So this is me. This is effectively just showing my contributions. And you can see it's just me and my buddy G, and who's TypeScript expert extraordinaire. So we're going to get to the interesting part here. We're going to get to the part where a lot of contributors join in. Any minute now. There we go. So here it's like, cool. Now all these people are contributing. Everything's exciting, right? It's pretty nuts. But to be honest, it's actually a little bit stressful. And we're going to talk about the pain points now. So as you can imagine, having all these people contribute is sure amazing. Thank you very much. But it's also very overwhelming. And as the platform grew, so did complexity, and so did the needs of the application overall. And now that we have so many contributors, I think we're like almost at 70 now, there were decisions that no longer involved just me. It was now a group of people. A great example of this would be design discussions, right? As you can imagine, discussing and let alone agreeing on anything across multiple time zones is extremely difficult. And beyond that, more pain points was, you know, the code base is growing fast, which naturally led to longer build times. Like, who would have thought that if you wrote more code, it would take longer to build? Crazy, right? And in addition to growing pains, we also made the decision to split up our application into multiple applications. So what do all the cool kids do these days? We create monorepos. So before we go any further, let's just briefly talk about what TypeHero is. If I had to describe TypeHero in its MVP form, I would say it is like LeetCode for type challenges. So if anyone has ever done LeetCode before, you basically get an interactive editor and you just have to solve some challenge. Just in the case of TypeHero, you just have to solve a type challenge. The cool thing about this project is it's open source. So here's some of the contributors that have helped make this project a success over the past couple of months. And if you're interested in helping us or, you know, steering our roadmap in some direction, we'd be more than happy to have you. But to tie this back to Next.js, we'll go to the core experience of what Type Hero gives you. And that's just the interactive editor with a challenge to solve. So here you can see the editor. And if you recall from my previous points of why we chose Next.js, nested routes was a big part of this. So you can see here we have description, solution, submissions. And if you look at the URL bar, you'll see that as I click around, it actually changes the URL because we want everything to be linkable. To take it even further, we actually want comments to be linkable as well. So I can actually like take one of these comments here. So I'll just pick like a random one and then I'll just click that or enter that. And you can see that I can actually deep link comments, right? So you can imagine like a use case for this is it's like, oh, hey, I have a cool solution and you know, I see your solution, I want to share it to somebody. We want that use case. So what does this look like from a code perspective? So we mentioned file-based routing. So we have this directory here, challenge, that represents this view here. And you can see we have challenge ID, which is another, or ID is another directory that maps to this one, or this part of the URL. And here we can see we have comments that maps to this part of the URL, and then we have comment ID, which maps to this part of the URL. And then so forth and so on, right? We see we have solutions, and we have submissions. So if I click on solutions, right? We see the URL bar change, and you can just see how easy that is. One other thing I'd like to mention is just the experience with React server components. So this is a React component, right? I can actually embed all my server code inside the component itself. So you can see here, I'm getting server auth session, that's server code. This is actually a Prisma query. So if I look into this, open that up, we have a Prisma query here, and then I have my types for this function, and I can just share those throughout my application. So you kind of avoid the whole ceremony, like if you need API routes or, you know, if you're using pages directory with like get server-side props, this is just so much simpler and easier to grasp in my opinion. And since we're in here, there's one more thing I'd like to call out. I mentioned previously that build times are getting longer. So how did we address that? So we chose Turbo Repo for our official mono repo tooling. And we can see here that a build specifically for the web project, which is just typehero.dev, takes around 34 seconds. But if we use Turbo Repo's remote cache, we see that a web build takes 170 milliseconds. And you can imagine in CI, building this over and over again, it's gonna have compounding effects and you're gonna save a ton of time. So definitely check out the docs. If you haven't heard of Turbo Repo, you won't regret it. So let's talk about how the Vercel platform itself enables the team to move faster. So if you recall previously, we were talking about how the platform allows us to make decisions faster around design, for example. I'm gonna show you a concrete example of that. So we actually have an active PR that's doing some UI changes to the core experience in the editor. So I can actually go visit the actual environment here, and I'll go to exactly where the UI changes were. And they're just basically adding like some UI behavior here. So you can see how it just changes blue. However, we do have a test panel here and the behavior is missing here. So you can see I left a comment saying, you know, this should have the same behavior. So meaning it should just highlight blue. And the absolute insane part here is I can make this shareable with anyone with the link. So I can copy this link, paste it in the PR or DM it to them directly. And then they can see my feedback. So, you know, if everyone's familiar with GitHub, the PR process is really only good for reviewing code. It's not very good for actually reviewing like UI or design changes. The even crazier part here is that you can actually install this toolbar locally. So we have this as a local dependency. So you'll be able to see my comments as you're developing and, you know, just addressing them as you're coding. And that's like an absolutely insane experience. I mean, that's hands down one of my favorite things currently. I'd love to dive into more features that we're leveraging, but unfortunately we are short on time. So I'd actually like to take the remainder of this talk to one, thank Vercel for having me speak yet again at NextConf. This is such a huge privilege and I don't take it lightly. But more importantly, I would love to thank Vercel for building tools so average engineers like myself can turn ideas into reality fairly easily. I'd also love to thank the contributors to typehero.dev. Without you, we would not be where we are today. I love you all to death, and I honestly can't thank you enough. But I'd also like to take this opportunity to announce that we're actually now in early access because of all of your hard work. So if you are interested, please go to typehero.dev, join the waitlist, and we will get you on the next cohort of early access users. And we hope to get your feedback. We hope you find bugs more importantly. And you know, we hope you just enjoy the experience overall. Again, I don't take this opportunity lightly. I feel extremely thankful to be here and I'll see you all around on the internet. All right, trash out.